Good morning, students. I'm Kokila here. Today you're going to have a geography session, and now we are going to discuss the next chapter, migration. So here, these are the outlines of the chapter we are going to discuss one by one. So first of all, what is called a migration? Migration means a person who travels from one place to the another place. So that purpose of traveling, it can be anything that is temporary or just permanently if they want to settle down in that other country. So these are generally called migration. So if a person move from their own original country to the other, then that is called migration. And the person who involves in the traveling, so moving from one place to another, they are generally called migrants. Okay, so these are the reasons. So already we discussed about this word, the term migration, in the last lesson, population dynamics, which means why people are more in one country, another country sometimes it is less, why. So already a lot of things we discussed in the previous lesson itself. So here we are going to see only in depth of migration. So this is what the definition of a migration: movement of people from their home to another city, state or country for a job or for a shelter is called migration. Okay, students, and now we are going to see the more specifically immigrants. So if I'm going to go away from my personal particular country, means then I'm called immigrant. And if a person is, for example, to our India, if some abroad people, some foreigners are coming to our country, means then they are called immigrants, or that is called immigration. Okay, fine. So here there is a one particular paragraph. So human migration, when it was started and what is the reason behind the migration and what are the impacts if migration happened in this world. So here there is a word epoche in history, which means the entire era. So the world, it was something very different in the starting time with the random amount of people in a different places. But very gradually it increased according to some reasons. So some positive reasons also there and some negative reasons also there. So why people started to move themselves from one place to another place? So what are the reasons? Why, how come the population demographic has been changed? So this is what we are going to see. And some examples it's given here in this book. A few examples of a migration. So during the year 1846 to 1940, some mass migration occurred worldwide. And around 55 million of migrants moved from Europe to America, and an additional 2.5 million moved from Asia to America. So most of the countries, continent people, started to move themselves from their own country to America. So it is all happened between 18th to 19th century. So why, what is the real reason why do they want to change their own country itself? So the first major reason is their labor migration. So mainly for their job purpose, people are interested to move from their own country to the other country. And these large migration flows influenced by the process of nation state formation in many ways. So migration gives some positive impact also. So people can have some close relationship with each others. So it is a very good start for the state formation in many ways. And apart from that, some other example of migration: the 20th century also experienced an increase in migratory flows caused by wars and politics. Here this is a world, it's not polities, it is called politics. So due to the war, so people are not interested to live in their own country itself. So they want to go away somehow. So flee means escaping from their own country itself, whatever the things, major things they want, important things they want. and they have taken from their own country, from their own home, and they immediately wants to leave their original country to some other country. So due to war and some politics purpose. So about 400,000 of Jews moved to Palestine. So Jews means that is Judaism religious people. So they moved to Palestine. So Palestine, that is presently it's called Israel. So these many peoples, they started to move to Palestine and in the 20th century. And not only that, some Russian civil war happened, and these civil war makes some Russians and some Poles means Poland country people, so, and Germans to migrate out of Soviet Union from their own USSR, from their union itself. So these people, they wanted to move away from their original place due to the war and so many other negative impact of the migration. So here you can see the picture. So migration of Jews to Palestine in the timing of 20th century. Okay, students, and these are the examples. And now we will see the causes. What are the main reasons why people want to leave from their own original country? Nowadays, many people decide to migrate to have a better life. So generally, you have to think by yourself why people want to leave their original country or from their own place to the other place. First of all, for their employment opportunities or for their higher education or the better medical facility, or for some safety purpose, or for some globalization or natural disaster. So these are the major reasons why people wants to leave from their own country to the other country, or from their own village to the city sites. So now let us discuss one by one. So migration shows the trends of social change from the historical viewpoint during the process of industrialization and economic development. So this is a point that people wants to leave their village. So now let us consider a village people. So village people, they wants to leave their own village and and they wants to live in some city region. So why? So to earn some lot of money, because if they are continuously, if they are sitting in village itself, it cannot help for their future development. So that's the reason people started to leave their village and started to move to city sites and all. So here you can see a picture, global migration. As per the United Nations, it is a positive force. So when people are moving in the name of socio-economical development, so there is a lot of positive impact only we have received. So in modern times, technological changes are taking place in Asia, Africa, Latin America and US. Okay, students, and now we will see. So what are the major reasons so involved in this? So there is a term introducing here, push and pull factors. So this word already I hope you still remember. So push and pull factors are the major reasons forcing a person to move away or going to a particular country. So now let us see what are the push factors. So you just imagine yourself, if you're living here in one particular area, what makes you to leave this place immediately? Okay, so what are the things makes you to leave this place immediately? So those factors are generally called push factors. So forceful factors. So here these are the reasons. If you see poor medical care, I do not have a proper medical facility. And according to my qualification, there is no proper job. So a lot of drought and natural disaster happens. Loss of wealth. So fear of torture, high rate of crime and lacking of safety. Political fear, religious factor. So these are the things which is disturbing us mentally and physically. So these reasons makes us to leave our own country itself. So now let us go to the next factor, that is pull factors. Pull factors. What are the things attracting us to go one particular country? For example, if we all are living in Jodhpur presently, if you are not interested to live here, you are you have one choice. Maybe you want to live in some metro cities. So what are the reasons behind it? Why do you want to live in some metro cities only? So some attraction points. Chances of getting a better job, better living condition, comfortable geographical and climatic condition, better educational opportunities, medical care, security, social as well as religious, better infrastructure of transport and other social benefits, and family links. So students, these are the major reasons, push and pull factors, always making us to move from one place to the another place. Okay, now we will see the next heading, that is called effects of migration. So if you migrate yourself, so what are the things will happen? So now let us see two different types of in India, what is called the socio-economical structure if you move from one place to another. So let us start from the economical effects. Economical effects means if you move away from your original place, are you going to face any financial gain? Are you going to have any financial gain? Are you going to get anything positive to your family? So that is what called economic effect. So this particular paragraph is saying nothing but, you just imagine now, you people, you just imagine you are living in a city. Sorry, you are living in a village. So village means, you know very well, there is no proper basic facility also. So those farm people, the villagers, if they want to leave their own village and if they are interested to live in a city, definitely once all the people evacuated from their particular village, means their village will be totally free from people. So the land will be empty. So people, they are moving to some city region and they are getting some new job there and they are earning really a very fancy salary, very good salary, and they are started to give those salary to their family member who is locating still in the same village. So with the help of those amount, people will start doing some better thing which can improve their lifestyle. So those who immigrate to urban, so those villagers who migrate to urban are mostly in the age of 18 to 40. So these are working age group people. So they started to work and remit their savings to their homes at villages. Remittance means sending. So their savings amount, they are started to send to their family people who lives in rural area. And they are started utilizing that amount and they want to improve their lifestyle by getting some proper basic facility for their household, electrical, electronic goods. Whatever they want. So these kind of things will happen if the villagers are moving to the city region. So this is called economic effect. So moreover, when these migrants return to their village occasionally, they try to raise the consumption and living standards by bringing new ideas and goods to their homes. So this is what I was telling, some household gadgets they will start to purchase, TV or fridge, motorcycle, some basic things which they want in their day by day life. So this will be, these people will earn only if they move to city region. So further, with the migration of working these were age people, if they are working in urban region, the number of farm workers will be reduced in the village region. So this leads to employment of underemployed. So number of people who was not having a job in rural region, they started to get their own job in the city region. So number of people started to employ. So, they are doing some job. They became employee in some companies. So they started earning a lot of money. So in future, when they are coming back to their own rural area, to their village, they can give some better opportunity to their family, small people. Their youngsters, they will get a lot of amount from those people who went to city and came back. So people can produce some proper, they can use the land in a very effective way because they can buy all the agricultural related transport purpose or the proper crops, or they can do anything in their own land because they started earning money. So they'll become rich because they started earning money in the city. So with the help of those saved money, they can come back to their own village itself and they can use that money to their land. They will invest in a proper way. They will earn something in a better way. So now we will see the social effects. So social effects means once people started living in a city region, so what will happen? So socially, so our emotions will be changed, our lifestyle will be changed. So people will start, if you just imagine if a villager goes to any city region, so the villager will forget about their own originality. That originality will be completely, it will be vanished. So definitely because people started liking the city lifestyle and they want to improve their own lifestyle into city side. According to the city side, whatever it is possible, they will try to impose everything. So in that way, the original thing of their family tradition, everything will be forgettable and the new lifestyle will begin. The remaining we'll see in the next video.